Now, this is the Microsoft Wireless Display Adapter. And I need this one because this TV in the background, it's a Samsung TV, that is not able to, it's not able to get a connection for screen mirroring. So when I switch there, there is no, at the source, there's no screen mirroring at the background. And now when I plug in this screen mirror, Microsoft Wireless Display Adapter in the background. That's what we do here. Here's this HDMI port. Plug it in. And as you see, this is very long. It's not the best stuff. And here's a USB cable. You have to plug in both on the back side. And now when we switch on again, we go to the source. Now you see there's a HDMI 3 in the background. And this one is now I'm able to do the screen mirroring. Now when I take this one, come on. Here we have, where's the screen mirroring? Here it is. Screen mirroring. Now, this one works in the background. Okay. Now I will stop this screen mirroring because here, stop that connection. Running down. Okay. Because I have to update it. Now when I have this tablet. The tablet is not able to connect. The connection breaks. Because the update here it is. Now when we run screen mirroring there, it will connect. It tries to connect, but it breaks. It's not able. As you see, it always breaks in the background. It breaks, it tries to start and then it breaks. Okay, now what we have to do. Okay, breaking this one. What you have to do is, we have to go to, we have to use a tablet PC, Microsoft Windows 10, and one with a, which is able to do screen mirroring by itself, okay? Now, here we have connect, to connect. Now I may connect to the device, but when I'm able to do this one, I have here a PC. This is a, that's the other Samsung, that's also a Sony device, tablet, but the former, this one is 4 years old, it's not too old. In this device, I will see the connection. When I say okay, do the connecting, then I will see the device. Okay. Now, when I do the same stuff here on my other tablet, when I say here okay, go there and do the connection. Here is connecting. Then the stuff will not come because the system says this system is not Miracast, doesn't allow Miracast connections, wireless connections, because this is depends on Intel, on the Intel graphics driver. I don't know why Microsoft did this stuff. That's really terrible. Okay, I'm switching off this one. Now, what I want to do is I want to update the driver there of the stick. Excuse me. So what we have to do, we have to go in to here to the start button. And in the start button, we will see the shop, the store, Microsoft Store. And in the Microsoft Store, we say display this Microsoft wireless display adapter. And this is also quite buggy because it didn't run the first time when I prepared this show. Now I'm installing this stuff. Let's see, maybe it runs this time. Now it's downloading. Sometimes it hangs on there, okay? But now it does its job. And now I'm starting the app. Okay, now it says, okay, do something for the customer and also surveying. Okay, what we have to do is we have to go there on, we have to click on the notification button, and then we have to use the connecting. And now it says, okay, here's my device. In the other system, it was not visible. I connect the device. Now in the background, you see the background system also is now connected. And now its system says, give me access, will I allow the access to the app by the system, by the adapter, by the hardware? I say, okay, yes, do it. And now the reason why I'm doing this one is because it says here, my adapter, the adapter has is connected. Language is English of the adapter, and there's no password. And then the firmware is 1.2.73, and I have another one. Okay, the firmware of this one is, my firmware is of the adapter is 1.2.73, and I have 1.3, and that's too old. So I'm downloading the new adapter software, the firmware. I'm downloading it, and now I'm refreshing the firmware of the system. Okay, so I'm refreshing the adapter software on which it sticks now on the background. Adapter actually in the wireless is the adapter is ready, and don't disconnect and all that stuff. Okay, now I'm starting. It may take a while. Do not disconnect the adapter. In the background, you see what the system is doing. I think this is very terrible. It's a critical stuff. You see in the background, it is updating the firmware. So it's transmitting the firmware, and now it's rebooting. I think it's rebooting or transmitting and installing it in a ROM system or another on a EEPROM system or something like this. I don't know. Firmware update is starting, restarting the adapter. The update was successful. The adapter is restarting. You may need 60 seconds, up to 60 seconds. Okay. System comes up again. In the background, system comes up. Okay. And now the important stuff is, will this Samsung display be able to screen mirror after this point? 60 seconds. It said, I'm very disappointed by the stuff. But what else? Is it already running? I don't know. Maybe I have to connect it. Let's try to connect. Nothing happens. System runs in the background again. Ready to connect. Okay, now I'm connecting by this one. Tries to connect. Oh, I'm trying to connect by this one. I have to stop this one. Okay, I'm starting with this one because this was hanging on the maybe by the firmware. But the firmware says now is 1.3.8.35, so this is the wrong version. It didn't update the stuff. Firmware adapter 1.3 for something else. And now connecting. This one is there. Now when I say okay, what is my adapter doing? Okay, this one says firmware is on the latest edition. Now I'm disconnecting that stuff. I'm disconnecting it. This will need a while. And now the important moment will come. Now it's disconnected. Stop this one. Try the new one, a tablet. I'm starting my tablet and here in my on the tablet we have screen mirroring and I will see the display adapter. I tip on there. Now have a look on the background. Either it runs or it's still a bullshit. Now it's there, and this was the reason of how to update the stuff, and now it's possible to run all on my tablet. So I'm very proud about that. So this was my installation of my Miracast adapter. And now this PC, this TV is able to run those smartphones and all this stuff with the screen mirroring. And I hope I could help you also running this stuff. You could do the same, could be able to do the same with the Chromecast from Google. Maybe this has another way how it works. Now this one works and I'm quite happy about that because I had problems with this, and if you liked it, give me a thumb on there.